Good morning. Go back to Colonia and the old Polish farm. It's the end of August. Yesterday, what the heck were we doing? Oh, we were doing a harvest contract and it started raining on us right as we just got done. And then it kept raining through the rest of the day. And there wasn't much I could do. We had also been trying to bale the straw off of our oat field. And we hit the bale limit. So we had to try and figure out how to get that down. So what I did is I maxed out the food for the most part on the cow barns. So I fed the cows over at the other farm all the hay I could. And over here I mixed up as much total mixed ration as I could until I ran out of silage. So we actually emptied the silage pit there in mid-August. I think we'll be okay. Yeah, we should be okay, but yeah, we won't be able to mix up any feed for a while. But I don't think they'll eat their way out of it, but we'll probably be really busy mixing feed again once once they start working their way through it. So here's the cows. This is as far as I got them. Let's see here. Let me roll through them here and make sure nobody's ready to give birth. 70%. Okay. So yeah, we got the, there's still room for more feed, probably another 10,000 liters, which would be four more mixer wagons. But I don't think we'll get there. So yeah, the silage pit's completely empty again. Which is okay because September, we're gonna be ready to chop corn. We'll get it back in there and get it fermenting. We'll get it blanketed and still got the one box on the handy pallet is all. Chickens, how are they coming on the eggs? All right. This grass can be cut. Should be cut. Tedded for hay. I don't know how much bale space we have. We gotta try and get the rest of this straw off this field. It's all kind of garbage now. Got rained on. I think we got three bales baled before we hit the limit. I got them stacked over here. These are okay. So we got a loan, I don't even remember how much it was, so that we could purchase the, what was it, an oat field over there at the other place? I think so. So if we've got some space on the bale limit, maybe we can try and take some silage contracts. That's the best way to earn money quick. We do need to finish up the uh, that harvest contract that we did. I think it's going to Targ of all places. It's often going to WS Colonia when we have when we're doing a harvest, but someone do go up to Targ, I guess. We could possibly get some more harvest contracts, but the baling would pay better. Let's get done what we need to do here. We'll get the milk up to the dairy, and we should have some dairy products we can take over to wait, Targ. That's the market. I was thinking PGR. I think that's where our harvest is going. I wonder what Targ's got a great demand for. I thought it said great demand at Targ. Maybe it'll be one of the dairy products we're going to take over. Take this up to the dairy. Really zoomed out, huh? I know this looks like the shirt I was wearing yesterday, but this is a clean one. It just happens to be the same color. I don't want to do grass work, but it's the best way to make money. So that's probably what we'll end up doing. We'll have to lease some equipment if it's going to be silage bales. I'd like to do the, you know, get the round baler and that wrapper. Really, one of these days I ought to buy that stuff. Okay, it had run out of milk, but now it's got some. Let's move this out of the way. Get our truck over. Warm up a minute here. Two pallets of butter is what we got. That should be good. I like this forklift better now that I've figured out how to bring the forks back together. This would actually be good on Ohio Farm one, where I have the ridiculous production coming out of that general mill. I don't know if it would be any easier, you know, putting it into that warehouse, but certainly clearing the spawn area as quickly as those pallets come out. Being able to grab a couple of them at a time would be better. This truck really gets up and going pretty quick. This truck could actually work for baling, doing the small squares by hand probably. Anyway, as I was thinking, I think somebody made that suggestion. I was just thinking about the round bales, but they might have been thinking about small squares. All right, what'd we get? 3352. Nice. So, that's good. Tough corner in this truck. That was probably the worst I've done coming out of there, though. We can go deliver that grain from that oat harvest that we did. And then figure out what kind of money-making scheme we can come up with today. Still got a lot of bales to put away over at the other farm, too. See, yeah, we gotta cut that grass at ours. Let's take the hard surface road home. Corn is looking nice. So yeah, we'll be ready to chop that the beginning of September, I think. hate it when the cars come because they want to stop. They come too quick for me to be able to get in my driveway. Getting to the point where we're producing enough milk yet? I don't think we took any yesterday. That's why we had so much today. We'll see tomorrow. We'll give us a better indication of how that's going. Let's see. Let's park here. Kind of in the shade a little bit. I came over in the T30 last night, or yesterday afternoon in the rain, because I didn't have anything over there, really. The Omzi Big Blue is kind of parked in with the truck and the trailers and everything, so I couldn't get it out. So, that's what we'll take back, I think. Yeah, we need to get that stuff delivered. That's the next thing. I think there are a bunch of baling contracts for silage bales on the usual fields. This one here to my right. And then this trio of fields, not this one, but basically the other three. So the two on the other side of the creek by that road and this one here. So if we borrowed the Fortrett mower from the biogas plant, we could probably get those done in fairly short order. It should be probably worth doing. That would probably take most of the rest of the day for us. And then some. Who knows? Just failing gets tiresome. And it's the best way to make money. Lights on still. Put the T30 in there. So yeah, I was basically just putting hay bales in here, used all the bales that we had up in the loft. So there's none up there. And then I started taking them off the trailer here. Let me take a look at this, see what they're at. And I got that one that's a partial right there. So here at the bottom, I don't even think they'll take that partial one yet. Oh, get back in there. They are producing the manure. I wonder if how much this holds compared to how much they're producing. I may have to do something about that. The other one's overflowing at the other place too. So yeah, here's all the hay bales we still have left. They need to go up in the loft. Maybe we can use our this thing to get them up there. But first things first, let's get this contract delivered. Give me a second while I verify the delivery location for this. Okay, it's going to PGR. Get this over there. I prefer to do a harvest contract, but I think I'm gonna have to do the grass work for the money. I just wonder if I have the right of way at that intersection. Tip side right. Yep. That's how we get into our silo. Alright, so let's go ahead, deliver this. Almost made 1,000 euros. for the excess crop off the field. These don't pay much. I think it'll be about $1,800 to collect. Yep, $1,838. We almost have $10,000 though. I think the thing to do would be go right to the biogas plant, borrow their mower. Though, man, not sure it's what I want to get into when I have all that other work coming up. Leave it that way. I must have. Intake for a pump. Looks like it. Let's see, so I won't, if I'm just cutting, I'll only need the cutter head. Accept those contracts, I guess. So field 19, 20, and 21. Let's just quickly get it done as a time lapse.
Over the edge. I'm floating through the air. The pain I felt is paid for, all is said and done. Oh, I am restricted, fixed upon the web. I need to kick the habit that my mind is breathing in. Break out, I've got to see. Spent all my life holding all of it closely. I played it innocent, a feel of discontent. I'm finally facing it all, fearless.
Fortunately, we're right by the farm over here, so what I'll do is I'll just run up there. We'll have lunch, make a phone call up to the machinery store for the equipment we're going to need to lease to finish these baling contracts for solid bales. And then Yamsey's right over here to grab to run the baler. Grab something to eat, then we'll grab the Yamsey and go grab the baler. We'll see you after lunch. All right, finishing up lunch here. We made the phone call, so everything should be ready for us over at the machinery store, the leased equipment, the baler, the wrapper, and the trailer that we normally lease from them. It's all available for us, so let me grab Yamsi and head over there. We'll get on the baling. This will be fun. Can I articulate my way out of here? So, I think I better go grab some fuel on the way, huh? I wonder if going the back way would be quicker. Not sure. So yeah, we got all the grass cut, so it should be fairly easy to pick up because the mower kind of windrows as it goes along. That saves us some time. Let's see. Two of the contracts are actually going to the biomass energy plant, South Biomass. One of them is the biogas plant. So that contract, we will end up selling the bales at the biomass energy plant and failing the contract. I don't know which of the three it is off the top of my head, but it works out that it's roughly about the same payment when you do that. This will pay well. Oh, Lord. That's the first time I've ever had that happen. Wow. Okay, I'm gonna end up going in this guy's field. Get out of the traffic. Did you see how much that... it articulated. Wow, that's pretty cool. Wasn't cool, the crash, but the fact that the front part of the tractor articulated to the side so much, that's pretty neat. Just shows you how the models are designed to rotate and everything. Let's go get some fuel. That would have smashed that car. I don't think we did anything other than hit our tire. I saw some news article saying that fuel had gone down. It's like, yeah, I don't know. It's not what it looked like when I experienced the last few fill-ups I've put in. I think when we make some money, we probably should look into buying this round baler. We lease it a couple of times every year, it seems like. We got more land we want to expand to. Okay. Turn on, we'll drop down the pickup, and let's start bailing. It works best if you lift the pickup when you're backing up. All right, first bail's out. Which means start the time lapse. Done with the bailing here. I'm not quite sure why I'm picking up these scraps because I'm not going to get a full bail out of it, but I don't know if maybe I'll hang on to the equipment for another. Don't roll away. Oh. Yeah, it's getting late in the day. This is not great. I might have to keep working on this into the dark. It's gonna rain too, so that's not great either. What I'm gonna do is I'm gonna grab the portrait mower. I'm gonna drive that back over to the other farm so I can wash it there with our pressure washer. Gonna need that for the trailer, I think, but yeah, we'll grab this, we'll head over to the other farm, we'll grab the wrapper, and we'll have to get the belt spikes on the T25 and get to work. We've got some equipment to move around here. Driving some transition in, but we'll try and get as far as we can. Okay, I've got everything moved around, set up over there in the field, and I have to apologize for the audio. I've come back in and I've got to overdub this. I don't know what was going on with the microphone when I recorded this last bit, but it was out of control. It sounded like an airplane was flying overhead the whole time. The voice was all distorted and stuff. It was just really bizarre, and I don't know why it did it. So I've got to overdub this part, and yeah, there's not much game machinery noise or environmental noise for this last bit of the clip here, but we've got all the equipment moved over here into the field. So I've got the Zetor on the wrapper and the Yamzi on the trailer. And maybe I shouldn't have put that bale. I was going to do that one first and I forgot. See if I can slip past it here and get it on there. Yeah, I can. All right, good. So we're going to try and see if we can get these wrapped. I was thinking it was probably a mistake to pick black wrap, but then I realized that I'm just going to be taking it off the back of the wrapper here and put it on the trailer. So it's not like I'm going to be hunting for black wrapped bales in the field in the dark, which would not be a good thing. You want to use white if you're going to end up having to do this in the hours of darkness. I thought I had automatic drop on, but I don't have the tractor running, so I gotta do that. That should drop it off the back. Yep, there it goes. Okay. So we got that. And we'll get this one on here. So I think I'm resigned to probably having to keep all this leased equipment another day, because I don't think there's any chance of getting this done tonight. And also, maybe I could take another one tomorrow, or I could also use the baler to bale that kind of trash straw that we have up off that oat field to get rid of that, and you know, do larger round bales, so it'll be a little quicker to accomplish. I'm not sure, I didn't even count how many bales we're going to get off of these fields, but we should be able to get it taken care of. Now, two of them are going to the South Biomass Energy Plant, which is basically the regular bale sell point. So we'll be able to do those contracts, you know, as normal. And then one of them is supposed to go to the biogas plant. We'll just deliver those to the South Biomass Energy Plant. Let's sell them all. Fail the contract, but it'll come out to be about the same. I think I said this once already. I don't remember what I was talking about when I actually recorded this. But I'm going to try and get as much done as I can. Oh, one thing I did realize is that I'm going to have some more work to do tomorrow before we can start doing the corn silage, because my silage trailer is full of straw bales, so we got to get those bales out of there so we can do it. So let's get these strapped, and I think we'll do the rest of this pretty much as a time lapse, and that way the sound problem won't be so bad. So let's do that. I think discretion is the better part of valor here. It's getting dark, and rather than continue to try and hunt the bales in the dark, I think I'll just get these two loaded onto the trailer and we'll call it a night. I think you saw that last one. It was a little difficult to find it, and I don't know, I just spend a lot of time searching for a bale in the headlights. In the field. I think there's still a couple more in this field, but I think they're up towards the top, and I could probably find them, but I think probably the best thing to do is just go ahead and get these loaded on and call it a night. Then we'll finish the other field tomorrow, and we'll be able to see in this field and see if we missed any. I mean, a lot of times you do a baling contract, and sometime later you see a bale over by the fence or at the edge of the trees, at the edge of the field that you just didn't see. So we want to try and get paid for all these. We'll end up having to keep the equipment an extra day, but that's all right. It'll only cost us, well, not too much. We'll make up for it. It'll be all right. I mean, this will pay fairly well. And then we got a lot of work we got to get done tomorrow before we can get started on the chopping the corn. We got to get the straw bales out of that silage trailer. And yeah, finish this up. Probably take some milk up and strap this. And I think I'm ready to call it a night. So I want to thank you for hanging out with me here. Colonia, the old Polish farm. Get these lights off. I hope you enjoyed it. If you did, hit that like button. And if you don't subscribe yet, why not? Don't cost nothing. We'll see you next time. PlayStation.